So I grew up on the water down there, sailing actually, little small boats. Knew I wanted something to do something on the water. Didn't know what maritime was. Ended up here.
I grew up spending my summers in Sackett's Harbor, New York, on Lake Ontario. And I saw the Great Lakes shipping line, especially along St. Lawrence. So I knew eventually I wanted to end up somewhere on the water. I'm one of two company commanders for the engineers. I'm the Foxtrot company commander. I keep the engineers accountable. I make sure that they are on watch, maintenance. I make sure that they know their assigned duties, and from there, they are able to apply their skills to do them.
I'm a marine engineer license option student in my final year of engineering classes here. This is my final cruise. I'm the deputy corps commander at shore, and I'm the Echo CO here on the ship. I had no idea what the maritime field was, had no idea what engineering was in this engineering degree. And it turned out that I really enjoyed it and really liked it, and here I am today. The biggest thing that I liked was it was a hybrid of all the engineering degrees in one, so mechanical, electrical, we have some civil in there right now.
I didn't just have to specialize in one, I had to specialize in all, and I got training all across the board.
And the rest is all mocked into the last 10% of the degree, so it was very diverse. That's what I liked about it. It's kept me on my feet, not being boring, just one thing all the time.
So we have our hands directly in the fueling of the vessel. We have our hands in the cooling of the vessel. That's air conditioning, that's cooling the engines. Everything that has to do with moving this vessel propulsion-wise, that's directly in the engineering plant.
The Kennedy is a steamship. Steam is more a thinking man's game. Diesel's more of a working man's game. Steam plant relates to onshore facilities, because most of the power plants are steam. Even if they're generated by nuclear power, it's still a steam plant, or if it's natural gas, thermal, electric, it's still steam run. With my degree, you can take the fundamentals of engineering exam, which then will lead to your professional engineering license. And then if you want to go shoreside, that license is good as gold. Most shoreside plants would have you as an operator and the boards working the steam plants. Also, Professor King and Professor Coleman have worked diligently to start a program with STP to have you transition into the nuclear side of things. And there's a couple students that have had internships currently and previously and have gotten jobs out of it and to get their nuclear license.
A&M in general, being such a large university, has so many capabilities of helping us all, air, land, sea, everything. A&M in Galveston had the Maritime Academy. We're right in the port of Galveston. We have the ability to see every single day from the classroom what our future looks like. And for me, that's why I came to A&M Galveston.